My name's Ian Walshe, and I'm the program leader for clinical exercise physiology. We have a range of labs and facilities available really for expertise of staff and what students will want to get into. We have our Sports Central, which has a physiology lab, it has a teaching lab, it has a biomechanics lab. Within those, there'll be taught a number of range of skills, so it might be ranging from spirometry, looking at lung function, right through to ECG, so how the heart or the electrical activity of the heart is working. We also have specialist labs as well, so within those we can look at vascular function, we can look at blood pressure, we can also look at transcranial magnetic stimulation, so how does the brain interact with the muscle, and those kind of tools and skills that students will need for employability. At the beginning of the year, students offered opportunities or placement opportunities within our department, but also externally as well. So some students go on to do placements at the local hospitals. Some people do placements in rehabilitation classes and those kind of things. So there's lots of opportunities that we give students at the very start of the year to help them with their CV and their employability. So I mean, our program is specifically designed for employability, essentially. So our clinical competencies module is a very practical based module. We show people how to perform these tests to help with diagnosis of whatever condition it might be, and each week is a different condition. We also have an exercise prescription module, so if somebody has a particular condition, what's the best type of exercise to do for that particular patient population. So this is all very much geared to employability when they're out there in the real world. Students can go on to a whole range of occupations afterwards. So typically a lot of students will apply for the scientist in training program within the NHS. So this might be a program in vascular science, it might be respiratory and sleep science, it might be cardiac science. Other students might go on to do PhDs in a particular area, so it may be looking at, again, older people with sarcopenia or something like that. Some people go on to do sort of pre-registration jobs within the NHS, so actually being respiratory physiologists. Some go on to health and wellbeing physiologists in the private sector.